సుప్రభాతం, సుస్వాగతం. సామరస్య శ్లోక సంగ్రహం. దిస్ ఫార్మ్స్ ది స్పెషల్ డైమెన్షన్ ఆఫ్ అవర్ ఇండియన్ కల్చర్. దర్ ఇస్ యూనిటీ ఇన్ డైవర్సిటీ. వెదర్ జ్ఞానయోగ, రాజయోగ, యోగ, కర్మయోగ, దేర్ ఆర్ కామన్ ఫ్యాక్టర్స్. And if you don't understand these common factors, there could be conflict. Many people think, yes, Bhakti Yoga is the highest. Some people say, Jnana Yoga is the highest. And there is the problems that arise. But if you understand there are common features among all these streams, they can all work together. This is what Swami Vivekananda emphasized. While he defined four streams of yoga, he said doing by work or worship, philosophy or psychic control, by one or two or more or all of these and be free. What is the goal? The goal is to reach that absolute freedom called moksha. That's why we call the mokshartham. The goal of human life is to reach that perfection of infinite freedom. Freedom from what? Freedom from all our tensions and stresses. Freedom from all our diseases. Freedom from all our bondages. What are the bondages we have? Bondage of the mind. The mind goes on thinking and thinking and thinking from morning till night. Can you tell your mind, be silent? It doesn't hear you. Bondage of the emotions. We are tossed up and down in various emotional surges. Anger, greed, jealousy, hatred, infatuation, arrogance. We are tossed up and down, up and down. Similarly, what is the bondage of the intellect? Ignorance. Our knowledge is so small. In the infinite knowledge base, we have very, very, very small knowledge. And the bondage of the body. The body has to be fed, has to be made to drink and maintain that. Can you overcome all these bondages? Bondage of the body also? That is the moksha. Freedom from all bondages. That is the goal. Whether you take the path of intellect through Jnana Yoga, or take the path through Bhakti Yoga through emotions, or take the path through the willpower, Raj Yoga, the Patanjali Yoga, or convert every action into Yoga, the Karma Yoga, you reach the same goal. All paths lead to the same goal. Not only that, the end point is same. Whichever path you go, even when you practice the different yoga streams, you have commonalities. So this is what has been brought out in this stream, the schematic. Initially, what are the eligibility criteria? It is same. For all the four streams, it is same. Your intense desire to change yourself and to follow a set of do's and don'ts, yama and niyama, and the tamasikalsi, consatvic actions, and all these things. You have the eligibility criteria. Then you start the journey. How do you start the journey? By changing ourselves. Using all our capacities to continuously change, to become great human beings. From our normal level, we have to move towards the great human beings. What's our normal level? In the normal level, now we are drawn by the three gunas, Daivi and Asuri Sampada. And what is being great? Convert all tamasic, rasic action to sattvic action. Develop the Daivi Sampada. What characterizes the great human beings is Dana, Daya, Dama, as I have been mentioning. By this process, you start becoming great human beings. That is not there. From the great human beings, you have to transcend the gunas. And you have to go into become super human beings. Transcendence starts with realization, with samadhi, with sakshatkara. And that is the process in which you expand yourself. There is an explosion inside. You move from a normal level of consciousness and operation to a higher level of consciousness. The higher level of consciousness is called Samadhi by Patanjali. And in Bhakti Yoga it is called the Sakshatkara. Jnana is part of the realization of the Jnana. And there you start fathoming the higher laws, the laws of the Pranamaya Kosha, Manomaya Kosha, Vijnanamaya Kosha, Anandamaya Kosha. And as you start growing higher and higher and higher, your various levels of samadhi, various levels of sakshatkara, various levels of realization, going higher and higher. What characterizes that? Higher knowledge, higher bliss, higher freedom, higher power. And these higher powers are called supernatural powers. And they are called as the siddhis. We are Hanuman. About Hanuman Chalisa we chanted. An embodiment of the highest order of the yogis. Because he was a Jnana Yogi, Raja Yogi, Bhakti Yogi and Karma Yogi all put together. And Hanuman, reached the highest heights with all the powers, with all the total knowledge. And finally, you reach the highest realm, going beyond all the kosha. And that is the moksha. This is the journey that takes place when you start practicing. So how to practice? Start off with a strong will, a strong desire, an ambition to change ourselves, to become better human beings, great human beings, super divine human beings. And use all of our power to see that we use this power for the good of the society, for the good of the people around us, for bringing peace on earth, harmony, peace, love and others. That is the dimension of yoga that is brought forth in all the four streams of yoga. In tune with that, our Prime Minister, with a single speech, brought yoga, the International Day of Yoga, on June 21st every day. I was wondering how even the 45 Islamic countries immediately came forward and supported this movement. Otherwise there used to be so much of negativities, criticisms, and all negativities about yoga. All these things were erased in one single talk by our Prime Minister, and they were declared as June 21st. Then it is not just one day celebration that has to be done throughout the world. Of course, that one day celebration started increasing year after years. And when it started, it was 20 crores of people who practiced the common yoga protocol in our country. And the next year, it was 26 crores. And last year, we had 30 crores of people who practiced. And more people have started practicing in every local corner, every little religious things have started practicing. And all over the world, more and more countries have come forward. And almost all the countries, 230 and odd countries, practice this common protocol in this thing. And this is where we have to adopt. So when you go back, you follow this common protocol, which consists of all the four schemes of yoga, Jnana Yoga, Raja Yoga, Bhakti Yoga, Karma Yoga, 40 minutes program, and you can download from the website these protocols, and you invite that, you start practicing and teach the people. It's the minimum that all people should do. And this is one vision that we have. Maybe we will be able to spread this message of yoga to a large number of people. As yoga instructors, you know much more than that, and you must follow this practice and spread this practices everywhere. Then our Prime Minister said, unless it goes into our education system, we will not be able to bring about the necessary transformation. Because some people may practice. How many people may practice? They may practice one day and then forget about it. But if it goes into our education system, it will become part of our entire life. And this is us, what there in our Gurukula system of education. Therefore, he told the Ministry of Pichardi that yes, it should go into the education system. So, in the child, in the preschool and kindergarten and others, we need to bring this yoga right there. We have got a big institution called National Council of Teacher Educators, NCTE. In NCTE, every year in our country, 13 lakh teachers are trained and yoga was made compulsory. But there were a lot of resistance. No, we should not bring yoga. Yoga should not be started at young age. And there was many cases that came up. Finally, the Supreme Court ruled, yes, it has to be done. And in our country, it was a big thing that happened. And the NCTE started bringing this yoga dimension. So, at all levels start coming. Then the NCERT, which takes care of the primary education, high school education, middle school education. And there again, yoga was put forth at two levels, level 1 and level 2. and we are all given the mandate to prepare the syllabus for that. We led and then prepared two books that are available. You can take from NCERT and you can bring this into all the schools. So the NCERT has sent all schools, you know, primary school, middle school, high school, yoga should be made compulsory. It has been sent to all the states, and many states have started incorporating that in the school education. Then came the UGC, University Grant Commission, to bring in yoga into higher education. In the higher education also, yoga should be brought, and syllabus had to be made. So a committee was formed by UGC, it was headed by our university, and we prepared the syllabus for the bachelor's degree, for the master's degree, for the doctoral program, and even this entire thing is available, and you can go into the website of UGC, you can get the syllabus. And therefore it came into the higher education system also. And this is how yoga has been brought into the education system in our country, and it should spread into all other countries as well. And taking the lead from here, it can come. What is the purpose of bringing yoga? It is to see that there is going to be a transformation of the personality, to raise them over normal Americans, good human beings, great human beings, and reach the highest stages. And that is going to bring about the necessary transformation of the whole world. And yoga is the real tool for this total transformation. And that starts with our individuals, every one of us, to start transforming ourselves. Then only the country, the world will change. Otherwise, talking about world peace, world harmony, world bliss things is only a hearsay, and it cannot happen. Therefore, Swami Vivekananda was very, very clear in his direction. Yes, we have to start transformation from the individual. He said, we and me. You know. Then the health ministry came forward, and our Prime Minister said, India is soaring high in diabetes, and we are competing with China to become number one, the diabetic capital of the world. Can we mitigate this? Yes. We have done a lot of research over the last 40 years about diabetes, and we have been able to show on published papers as to how yoga can help in mitigating diabetes. And we have published nearly 26 research papers in which we have shown that yoga can bring down the diabetes and even people can become normal. So when the curve is growing continuously up there, what is to be done? The curve should be brought down. How it can happen? When the pre-diabetics will not become diabetic, the curve will become horizontal. Therefore, we took up a whole study in the country. And this was supported by the Ministry of Ayush and the Ministry of Health and Family Welfare, in which they supported. And we had 1,200 teachers who were trained, and we took 60 districts. We scanned 2.5 lakh people in the whole country, the ever biggest research project in the world, in the randomized controlled trial. And using this thing, we have been able to show that the yoga group who practice yoga, the pre-diabetics, will not become diabetics. People who did not practice yoga, they increase. For example, the pre-diabetics, you know, they about 20% increase, you know, in the control group, whereas in the yoga group, there was hardly 2% increase. So this clearly shows that the pre-diabetes can maintain the pre-diabetes and even become normal. So this is by which the curve can come down like this. Then the mild diabetes should become normal. So again, we have shown by the yoga group in the control group, yoga group has started bringing down the diabetes. You know. And this is how the curve can be brought down. In that huge study, we have made this observation, and in every different state, we divided the whole country into 7 zones. Every zone has this thing, and we went to the district level and brought this. And those of you who want to associate with this movement, which is going to become a national program, we submitted all these reports. You know, the central report was about 530 pages, and every zone about 230 pages, about 2,000 pages of report was submitted to the Prime Minister 4 days back, and he was so happy that this big work has been done in 1 year. Earlier ministries have tried to do this thing, and they took 4 years, 5 years, spent, you know, hundreds of crores of rupees, but hardly they got the data on about 5,000 people only, that we were able to get the data on 2.5 lakhs of people. And this year, they have given a mandate that we take up the cancer control program. So this much bigger study we are going to launch on throughout the country, and this time we are going to have it in 100 districts, and we are going to scan 2 crores of people throughout the country and diagnose the head and neck cancer, the breast cancer and cancer cervix. These are the major cancer, and we will diagnose them and give them the awareness program to reduce that. And that awareness itself can bring down the incidence of cancer. We did a huge study almost 35 years back in the surroundings of Anegal district. I remember in those days, people were using so much of tobacco and then chewing tobacco, and therefore they had a lot of this oral cancer and head and neck cancer. Therefore, Kidwai member Institute of Oncology, Dr. Krishnamargava, joined with us, and we went around bringing this awareness. How did we bring the awareness? Told them what is going to be the horrors of the oral cancer. We showed the different types of pictures in our posters, in our other things, and our doctors table talked about it, and we projected in the video projection, and the incidence used to be 35%. It has gone into such big stage, and within 6 months it was all brought down to only 5%. And there was a big study that took place, you know, 35 years back. We have that background, and we have been having it at Yoga tradition. In the whole country, in all the districts, and with that you are coming from different parts of the country, and we can all take part in the big study that we are going to take up. 2 crores of people to be done is going to be the ever biggest project in the whole world. And after giving them the awareness, we again measure how it has been able to come down. And those people who need the necessary support, we are going to give them. The second dimension of the cancer control program is going to be a randomized control trial at a bigger scale. We have done a lot of randomized control trials and followed up for 1 year, and people who are having even the metastatic cancer, they have been able to get normalized, and we have a number of cases. And we have published nearly 26 papers, and we have a big study going on in Houston in MD Anderson Cancer Center. MD Anderson Cancer Center is the biggest center in the world in Houston, Texas, in the United States. And we are joining hands with them and do a big study of the initial study, first study, the pilot studies and other things, control studies showed importance of yoga as an add-on. And therefore, based on that, the National Institute of Health gave the MD Anderson a huge sum, $5 million, ever biggest grant for cancer. And we are continuing this 668. Patients of breast cancer in a multicentric trial, in a 3-arm trial, we are doing this thing, and we measure these things, and in another 6 months that will be completed, and in all oncology hospitals, yoga is going to become an add-on, because the usefulness of yoga has been so much more. And therefore, we are going to take up now a much bigger study in India, you know, about 10,000 people in the head and neck cancer, 10,000 in breast, and 10,000 cancer cervix in a randomized controlled trial, in a multicentric trial, and many, many cancer hospitals are involved. The healthcare global have got 26 cancer chain hospitals, and they all have come forward to do that and see that we have a randomized controlled trial in a very big study, and this can come. The third dimension of the cancer control program we have is the mechanism study. When you use yoga, how does it help in cancer? What are the evidence based? And how it brings about the transformation? How it brings about the immune strengthening? How the confusion of the immune system is gone, and immune system started recognizing cancer cells as their enemies and see that they smash them. And this is going to be the study of the mechanism. So we study what's happening at the brain level, at the autonomic nervous system level, in the biochemical level, and in the immune system level, and in the gene level. All that we study to understand the mechanism which is most needed. Similarly, we study what's happening at the prana level, the mind level, the emotional level, also in these people. And this is the big study of the mechanism study. That's the third dimension of cancer control program. And the most important is the palliative care, that's the fourth dimension. Today, when people get into metastasis and they have no palliative care facilities in the country, only 0.4% of such people have got facilities in our country in different hospitals and others. So we want to bring this palliative care facilities throughout the country. And 7,000 Ayush hospitals and 20,000 hospitals of the other thing, everywhere we want to bring in the palliative care center, and we will train a large number of people in palliative care. Therefore, we will be able to give the necessary support or some people who get into metastasis, and these people can improve continuously. What we want is their longitude, their eyes need not be increased, but as long as they live, their quality of life should improve. Their pain, suffering, nausea, vomiting, headache, all these things should reduce, and this is our objective. Therefore, bringing the total oncology, we are going to bring this dimension. These are the four dimensions that have been planned, and we have formed the best of the communities of the world, topmost research of oncology in the world. We have formed an international research advisory board. In the nation also, we have put a board of top oncology researchers in this thing, formed two big committees, and the Ministry of Ayush has formed these committees, and we asked me to be the chairman for this thing, and we have a wonderful thing. We had several meetings, we have prepared a big proposal, and it's going to go. And our Prime Minister was very happy that you are taking up this cancer control program throughout the country, and he said it should become the national program. So this is a big move. This is how we want to bring yoga to the people at large, to make yoga a socially relevant science. And we all have this opportunity to take part in this beautiful movement that the country has been posed. And in different parts of the country, you can take place, and those of you who want to associate with this big movement are most welcome to give your names, give it to Suman, or give it to Natesh, or your coordinators, and this is how we can involve you in the process. And this is how yoga has to be made socially relevant. Therefore, the benefits of yoga will go to a lot of people in the country, and we'll be able to meet the challenges that our country is facing and the world is facing. Therefore, here is a great opportunity for all of you having completed your YSA. I congratulate all of you for having completed this month-long program here at YSA. And also, people coming from different parts of distance education, they have also finished. And today, you had this nice home. We invoke the blessings of Lord Rameshwara, Saraswati, and the higher courses, the cosmic courses, to help us to develop ourselves more and more, to contribute more and more to the society, and see that we mitigate this growing menace of diabetes, and also the control and the NCDs. For that, I welcome all of you to participate in this big movement that our university has taken to give the lead. And in the process, we are bringing all the yoga institutions together. And we have Indian Yoga Association, we have all the top yoga institutions in the country. We have YOL, Shri Shri Ravi Shankar, we have Swami Ramdev, we have Jiri Vasudev, we have got Gayatri Parivar, we have got the Kaivalya Garments Yoga Institute of Bombay, we have got the Tamil Nadu Institutes. All these 18 Yoga Parampara Masters have been brought together in India Yoga Association, and we take up this big project throughout the country by this entire Indian Yoga Association. And the Brahma Kumaris and the Ramachandra Mission and other institutions are also brought forward, and we need all the volunteers to make this possible. The government has planned a 3-year study in which they will scan 1 crore of people in 100 districts. But we said we are going to do 2 crores of people in 100 districts, and we do that in 1 year instead of 3 years. So we need 50,000 volunteers. Join hand, and we are going to launch this on this January 5th, 6th, 7th, 8th, 9th when we have this cancer conference here. And the whole approach is combine the best of the East with the best of the West. Modern medical system along with the Ayush systems have been brought together. And that's how we are bringing all the ministries together in the health scenario, and see that we take up this big launch. And we all have great opportunity for doing these things, and you are most welcome to join for this cancer conference. In which we have today top experts from the field of Ayush, field of the modern medical system, will come together and exchange and tell them what is the latest today and how we have to go further, what is the action plan, how we can join together, how we can bring the synergy, the whole encounter. And that is going to be a conference starting on 5th to 8th, and 6th is going to be our main inauguration, in which we get all the union ministers, Anand Kumarji, Nataji, and Shipaji, and others have all agreed to come together, and we are going to have the launch of this cancer control program, and we develop the suitable protocols by various dimensions, and see that we herald ourselves to move this. This is how ORFA should get involved in the national program to mitigate the menace of the national communicable, non-communicable diseases. And on the other side, bring yoga right from our childhood to all our children to grow into the dimension. So in the education field, in the health field, our Prime Minister has given the biggest move and it should grow. That is said, in all fields, it should come. Navy, Air Force, and Army, everybody has been promoting that this yoga should come, and many, many conferences and then many, many training programs have been initiated, and more people have started coming up. And therefore, it's a big launch, which is the right direction that our Prime Minister has given to our country, and we have a great opportunity to achieve this dimension. This is how we can involve ourselves. But that we have contributed more and more to the society. And that is the feature that we have to achieve in this. Let's contemplate on this thought. Sit right with your eyes closed. Relax all parts of the body from toes to head. Take a deep breath and slowly breathe out. Beautiful smile on the face. Relaxation of the body level. Slowing of breath at the prana level. Calming of the mind at the mind level. Bringing the daivi sampat at the emotional level. And expanding our vision to totality at the jnana level. Are the features of the four streams of yoga. So look at the thoughts. Slow down the thoughts. As they slow down the breath, the thoughts also will slow down. As we slow down the thoughts, we can recognize the gap between the two thoughts. A thought comes, vanishes. Next thought comes, vanishes. There's a gap between the two thoughts. Silence. Recognize thought, silence. Thought, silence. Thought, silence. Going a little deeper, we recognize that silence has been there, is there, will be there, in which the thoughts come and go, come and go. Like clouds in the sky. So thoughts are coming and going in the chitta akasha, vast, infinite, blue sky. Imagine silence everywhere in which activity comes and goes. Akarmani karma, seeing the karma, seeing the actions in non-action, the vast infinite silence. That silence spreads everywhere, goes deeper and deeper in all the three dimensions. Silence. And silence is peace. Peace is bliss. Bliss is ananda. That's our anandamaya kosha. Let us tune ourselves to this ananda. Great daivi sampad, santosha. All the time that tripta sthiti, ananda sthiti, shanta sthiti. We have to anchor ourselves to this infinite silence, bliss, peace, harmony and love. And express that divinity. As Swami Vivekananda said, the goal of life is to manifest that divinity. Let us spread the fragrance of the bliss, happiness to everyone whom we meet by act of service, by giving and giving and giving. Come to Namaskar Mudra.